Hi. Right, so firstly I decided, I changed my mind, I was going to do it live tonight. But then I stopped and I thought people are going to be doing their own things, they're going to be out at restaurants, they're going to be out at pubs, they're going to be around families' houses, etc. So, but, cut a long story short, for once, I'll do a recorded video and we're going to start off by wishing all my friends and family, once I can see the camera, a very happy new year. Thank you for all the comments and all the wishes from other people already. And for those that have already gone through the new year, places like Australia, all the best over there as well, you criminals. What we're going to be doing is I'm going to do a very short show. And I thought what was quite prominent in 2022, apart from the obvious, is we've lost quite a few famous, wonderful people. So I thought what I'd do, my original plan was to go live and show some sort of respectful footage of these people in action in their heyday and try and get people to talk about what these people meant to them. So without further ado, I'll show you what I mean. Let me just drop this music and we'll switch across. So the first person, and we're going to have there's going to be one advert in this thing as well, because I'm now getting paid for advertising. So please, you can skip the advert if you want to, but just stick with it when we get there. The first person who I would say really sort of hit home that he's gone is this gentleman.
Even my mama thinks that my mind is gone, but I ain't never crossed a man that didn't deserve it. Me be treated like a pawn, you know that's unheard of. You better watch how you're talking and where you're walking, or you and your homies might be lying to chalk. I really hate the trip, but I gotta look. At the coke, I see myself in the pistol smoke. Fool, I'm the kind of cheater little homies wanna be like, on my knees in the night, saying prayers in the street light.
Yeah. We lost Coolio, passed away in January 2022. I won't say much apart from he was just one of those people that did a lot, I would say, for the entire music industry in regards to what he does. He did a lot for horticulture as well, but he was out there and he was himself, which was quite, yeah, it's a cool thing to be able to do. Okay, it's a bit morbid, I know. It's all about people we've lost this year, but yeah. I thought it'd be a good talking point. But then I realised there's nobody going to be available to do a live show with, really. Next.
Well, I better hire a relief bartender. Hello? Is there somebody on this phone?
Oh, hi, Miss Howe. It's me, Woody.
Woody, are you using this phone?
No, not really.
What are you doing, Woody?
Well, I'm just standing here holding it.
Woody, hang up the phone, please. I have to hire another bartender now.
Oh, no, Miss Howe, I'm really sorry. I swear I'll never do it again.
Okay, yeah, Kirstie Alley, in the 80s, she was a very attractive woman. Big hair. Big hair was very fashionable in the 80s. She was in Cheers, and in them days, Cheers was a little bit like a cheap man's version of Friends, because Friends wasn't really around in them days. So Cheers was a sort of series you used to watch when there was nothing else on. No, it was a Marmite series. Some people loved it, some didn't. I used to watch it all the time. I thought Cheers was hilarious. Woody Harrelson, you saw there, a very young Woody Harrelson. And who was the other one in it? The main barman was the guy with the big forehead. They take the mickey out of having a big forehead. Ted Danson, that was it. But yes, Kirstie Alley, Gone but not forgotten. I'm just going to move this over here because I can't really see what I'm doing where I am. Okay, next person we've said goodbye to this year.
Can save me. No one else can save me now but you. As long as the planets are turning, as long as the stars are burning, as long as your dreams are burning too, you better believe it that I would do anything for love.
Yes, what a character. Meatloaf, not just a rock star, he was also in films. He was an actor. He was in Fight Club, if you remember that. He played the guy with the man the moves. And if you've ever listened to sort of interviews and people talking to him, he was actually a really funny guy. He was sort of calm, cool, but a really good sense of humour as well. And he's just one of those characters that you're a bit like Freddie Mercury. No one's going to replace him. No one's going to suddenly become the new Meatloaf. Going to be missed, especially the work he does. The next one I don't know much about. I do apologise because I'm not into this sport. However, obviously, I do know this chap. The only thing I'd say my experience with him is he wasn't big headed, so he wasn't Ronaldo. I mean, he wasn't big headed in his sport. He was a true sportsman. He came across as doing a lot for other people, and yeah, talented. They did it. I think they showed something the other day where some of the top players. They showed how they were sort of, they had learnt their moves from him. Quite amazing how many different moves he actually brought to the sport. But I'm not going to go into it because, like I say, I'm not a football expert. There'd be a lot of people, and this is why I thought about doing it live, a lot of people who could have helped me along with some sort of history on this guy, on Pelé. Not this guy, Pelé, the one and only. Okay, next one you might not be that aware. And what I would say beforehand is this young woman started off in New York as a child star who really had to sort of battle her way up. And this is in real time, and you'll understand why I'm saying this is a real time thing. She battled her way to become famous, to become something. And it was one of these really sort of Cinderella style stories where she knew she had talent. And she pushed herself out there. Now, this was actually replicated in one of the films she was in. So if you don't know her yet, this will remind you.
First, when there's nothing but a slow, glowing dream that your fear seems to hide deep inside your mind. All alone I have cried, silent tears full of pride, in a world made of steel.
Okay, it's like the dance version of Rocky, you know. But in those days, it had massive influence on kids around the world. That one film, Fame, people were buying like stocking, like what they call them, pull-up stocking type things like they wore on the show, on the film. When they went to the gym and stuff like that. Yeah, very powerful, very motivated and inspirational woman. Okay. We're going to take a short advert, like I say. Now, please sort of bear with it. You can skip the advert if you want, but it's one of these modern drinks that are coming out, you know, people are queuing up for and stuff. So I've got to include it because social media is how this thing is being promoted. Okay. I'll see you straight after the advert. So I'm going to have my drink and speak to you soon.
Why be irate? Just to hydrate. Now there's a drink, which no one is queuing for. Dopaprine. Perfect before breakfast or with a healthy snack. And Dopaprine has hardly any side effects.
Warning. May cause symptoms such as
unwanted penile erection, dehydration, mistaken milk attraction, unplanned pregnancy, vomiting, diarrhea, blurred vision, acne and piss stains.
Yeah, so get out there and get yourself a bottle of Dopaprine. Couple more, right? The next person. Now, this is where I hope my audience would help me out with this. All I know about this woman is she got an OBE. She became a dame in the UK. She's very, very London-based all her life, from what I know. And again, very inspirational. She was very involved in the bringing the UK's punk culture into the fashion world. So there's your first big clue. And one of the things I admired about this woman is she stuck to her own beliefs. And because of that, British fashion in general became worldwide known for being a leader of fashion in certain areas. I mentioned punk, but I believe also sort of the 80s and everything else. Without women like this, without women with such devotion to her belief in regards to how fashion should be, we wouldn't have been anywhere like we were in regards to street fashion, says me with my polar neck jumper on. But if you know what I mean, if you were around in the 80s and probably 90s as well, I'd suppose, the out there clothing was because of people like this. So just have a listen to this. I think it was from the 80s, this chat show. But just see how she sort of sticks to her guns and backs herself up while remaining polite.
Yes. I mean, what sort
if they don't stop laughing, I shall tell the next person not to come on.
Oh, dear. You're not to laugh.
You can laugh. You can laugh, but look as well. It's really great.
Is this a winter collection?
Yeah. I've never met this response before.
What response do you normally get?
I don't know, people get really into it, that's all. They think it's just great, usually.
Is that a lampshade that she's got?
Oh, it's a crinoline.
Oh, crinoline.
It's a mini crinoline.
They've taken a mickey out of
it. How do they feel?
It's really comfortable.
But she's sitting there quite politely.
Well, of course it's comfortable. You sit down and it just disappears.
Here you are, Russell. Yeah. This is for you.
This is more me, yeah. Is it called anything, that?
It's just a very English look. It's got tweeds from the borders. I just love English fabrics. I think the fabric does everything. You can just make the most plain things and they're just I love this English look. Only the English can do tailoring
like
this.
Yes, but it's extraordinary that you can produce that right next to that other thing. That almost be good.
I just think that these things are just really sophisticated, if you don't understand that.
That is, but she looks like a chip shop, that one.
Finland is a chip shop.
It looks like a chip shop.
Come back, Sarah.
Can you imagine going to Sainsbury's in that in the morning?
It does not look like a chip shop. I look like a fairy.
Ah. Where would you wear it?
I wear it all the time.
All the time?
Yes, I always wear Vivian's.
I wore one of Vivian's outfits. The skirt was that short with a top exactly like that in black to a very, very grand charity ball in Yorkshire about just before Christmas. And I was the raffle lady and I went round and collected a record amount of money for the charity.
But you need a huge personality like yours to be able to carry it off, don't you? I mean, it depends what you want. If you want all the men on the building site to whistle at you, just wear it and you get a reaction. I mean,
but are they whistling for the right reasons?
Of course.
What are the right reasons for
that? They fancy you.
Yeah, she was a no frills woman. She was actually married to, I think it was married, or were they just together? I think they were married. Malcolm McLaren, who was the sort of the creator of the Sex Pistols, and I believe she actually created the outfits for most of the Sex Pistols clothing and gigs. A very, very polite punk. Now, if you know about the punk history, punks are all about rebelling against or going against the grain, and I'm not going to go into that, but she kept it on a level, very, very strong woman, and yeah, big respect. Okay. Next one needs no introduction. If you don't know who this person is, have a word with yourself. Rest in peace, is all I can say to this one. And thank you.
I only smoke weed when I need to, and I need to get some rest. Yo, where's the cess? I confess I burned the hole in the mattress. Yes, yes, it was me. I plead guilty, and at the count of three, I pull back the duvet and make my way to the refrigerator. One dry potato inside, no light, not even bread jam. When the light above my head went, I can't sleep, something's all over me, greasy. Insomnia, please release me and let me dream about making mad love on the heath, tearing off tights with my teeth. But there's no relief, I'm wide awake and in my kitchen. It's black and I'm lonely. Oh, if I could only get some sleep. Creaky noises make my skin creep. I need to get some sleep. I can't get no sleep.
The amazing Maxi Jazz. I can remember multiple times when people were in a nightclub and that came on, the dance floor was just full. It was just full every single time, and it kept going like that for months and months and months with that tune. Obviously, with Faithless, they've done some other good tunes as well, but that's the one that everyone remembers from the days of nightclubbing. Yeah, rest in peace. Another great musician. Now, this young chap, in his day, again, was a fashion leader. He was part of a specific genre of music, and he was from my home county. Now, the thing that people, a lot of people don't know about this guy is he spent a great deal of his life with mental illness, suffering from depression. People that know this gentleman will know exactly who I'm talking to. I'm obviously talking about Terry Hall from The Specials. Okay, and that concludes our some of our losses this year. And I know it's a bit of a morbid subject, but I just thought we've lost so many sort of key personalities this year that they deserve a mention. They deserve the respect. Obviously, on that list is Queen Elizabeth II, but obviously, I didn't want to cover that with a cheesy little video made for Facebook. There are others as well, which I haven't mentioned. It's just that I had to keep it to a certain limit. I had to keep it with a bit, perhaps with a bit of musical sort of theme. But yeah, you get my drift. There are others, and I apologise if they weren't mentioned and they're important to you. Okay. Let's bring it back up. The final thing I want to say to you guys is I hope 2023 is better for us all. I know some of you have actually had a very good 2022, so congratulations, you're one of the few. But yeah, so fuck off COVID is the first one. And let's just hope things improve, things get better, countries get cheaper to live in. And yeah, people just have a lot of success and joy and good family times in 2023. Because 2022, clearly, was the best year ever. You know what I mean? It was just awesome, wasn't it? It was, yeah, we'll leave it at that. Take care. Thanks for watching if you found time to watch it to the end. And I will speak to you in the new year. Bye for now.